Desk investigation design. Hold on, I've muted the sound. I'm in my living room at the moment, at my apartment. Okay. Folks, I want you to use your common sense now. In the middle. Yes, in the middle. Look, there is this thing called soap operas or sitcoms. You see? And I want you guys to just use your brains for a moment. Why is it that there are millions of people worldwide who are addicted to soap operas and sitcoms? A situation comedy, that's what sitcom is, and our soap opera is kind of the same, but basically it's a theater that's being recorded in series, and you need to watch each episode to get the whole story. Instead of making one big movie, they make a series of it. That's what a sitcom or a soap opera is. Okay, those soap operas and those sitcoms, what do they teach people? What are they teaching? What are those producers teaching you with sitcoms and soap operas? Are they learning you to let go of negative soul ties? Are they learning you to leave toxic and negative people? Are they learning you to gain discernment, to recognize danger? Are they learning you to trust upon the Lord Jesus Christ with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength? Are they learning you to forgive? Are they doing anything that may cause you to get closer to God and closer to Christ's purpose for your life? Let me think. No, they don't. So they don't point to Christ. They don't point to man's salvation. They're not pointing to deliverance, to peace, to rest. All those stuff arts promoted by sitcoms and soap operas. So, why are millions, including professing Christians, addicted to soap operas and sitcoms? Many of you are going to disagree with me or are going to get angry with me when I'm saying this. Just listen. Most of those actors that act in sitcoms and in soap operas, or in Spanish it's called telenovelas, most of those actors are witches and wizards. Most of them have made deals with demonic spirits in order to perform well on stage. And most of those producers of those sitcoms and, you know, soap operas, they are Satanists or Freemasons, or they're into Wicca. They're in some kind of dark art. So when they produce, you know, a soap opera or a sitcom, their source of inspiration is the demonic realm. And a demonic realm, consisting of fallen angels and Nephilim spirits, they are both against Christ, against God. So when the demonic realm inspires a witch or a wizard or anyone into the dark arts, when they inspire someone, it's always a motivation that furthers the demonic agenda. So Everyone that's linked to the demonic realm when they receive inspiration is from demonic spirits. So the productions that those producers make, those are linked to the demonic realm, all of those productions are the productions of demon spirits, indirectly. The demon spirits are just using those directors to write those scripts or to write those books. So basically, it's the work of demon spirits with the aid of their human agent. And then you have those actors, most of them are witches and wizards who make demonic contracts to perform well on stage. And those wizards and witches, they join with a satanic producer to make that those soap operas and sitcoms. So what good can come from a production that's originated in the demonic realm and that's exercised by their human agents? What good can come from it? People, or let me say saints, we need to get serious. Look, if you've watched a sitcom once, or if you've watched a movie once, okay, you've watched it. Or if you enjoy watching movies, okay, you can enjoy watching movies. There's nothing wrong with enjoying watching movies. It's not a sin to enjoy and like movies, okay? It's not. However, enjoying watching movies or watching an episode is totally different than being attached to a sitcom or a soap opera. And millions are attached, completely stuck to soap operas and sitcoms. And what do they gain with it? They're not gaining anything with it, because remember, those sitcoms and soap operas, most of the time they are demonic productions that's exercised through the human agents of the demonic realm. So those productions, they glorify Satan, they glorify the dark side, they glorify sin, unholiness, unrighteousness, cruelty, abuse, scapegoating, all those negative stuff is being promoted by sitcoms and soap operas. So when you watch such a production, you get attached to the ideas and teachings of demon spirits. And okay, if you've seen it once or twice, there's nothing wrong. But if you keep on watching them, and you see, you're establishing an open door in your mind to those demon spirits. And now you are in a soul tie with those demonic spirits. So now those demon spirits will use that soul tie to force you to watch that show. And there are people who have financial struggles, marital problems, they have problems with their kids, they have problems at the workplace. Some people are even, you know, suffering the consequences of sexual abuse that they endured as a child. There are millions of people with serious issues. Yet, the only thing they seem to talk about are sitcoms and, you know, a character on a soap opera. And there are people, you know, when they have to go to the toilet, they would, you know, raise the volume, like now, of the television, so that even when they are sitting on the toilet, they can hear and follow everything that's happening. And there are people even going nuts and crazy about what a character did to someone else in a soap opera. Hello? It's just acting. It's just a game. What you see is a production. It's fake. It's not real. And then people begin to defend, because when you're attached to a soap opera or a sitcom, you are in a soul tie with demonic spirits. And now those demonic spirits will force you to watch that show. That's how you have people that are bound to a schedule that they need to be at home at 8 o'clock, because at 8 o'clock the show begins. They have to be there, or else they feel as if they don't do it, that there's some danger going to happen to them. Seriously. So those people begin to adapt the philosophies and ideas that are presented in those sitcoms. Listen carefully, people. I'm not condemning actors here, okay? I'm not. I'm not saying you can never watch an episode of a soap opera or a sitcom. I'm not doing that. However, the moment you realize that you become attached to it, it is something wrong. Because that means you're under a spell. That means you're being bewitched through that sitcom and through that soap opera. I mean it. And you see, some people say that, well, soap operas are just distraction. Distraction from what? If you say soap operas are a distraction for you from daily life, that means that in daily life there are things happening that shouldn't happen, but you don't know how to deal with it, that's why you choose to be distracted. No, what you should be doing is looking for the truth, search for the presence of God, ask the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus to reveal you what your circumstance is. Ask the Father in Jesus' name to show you all truth and righteousness. Ask God to reveal hidden things to you. Ask God to guide you. Search for God's guidance and God's wisdom in your life. That's what you should do. Then you will have victory in your life. Then you don't need distractions. Because distractions distract. Okay? It takes away your attention from something, but it doesn't annihilate nor destroy the thing that's taking your attention from. So a distraction is taking your attention away from an object, but the object is still there. The distraction didn't destroy nor get rid of the object. Folks, the same thing I can say about video games. I'm not against video games. Video games are fun. I play video games from time to time on a PS Triple, you know, or the Wii. There's nothing wrong with such stuff. And on my YouTube channel a few days ago, we were at an electronics store and we were basically having fun at an Xbox dance program, and Shandri was dancing. So there's nothing wrong with games, okay? If you like to play games, there's nothing wrong with it, okay? However, the moment you become attached to gaming, you're in serious trouble. You see? Because listen carefully. When your attention is being redirected from something, of course that something is still there, but you ask yourself, if your attention is being taken away from somewhere, where is your attention being led to? A distraction, like I mentioned before, I'm still going to show it. You have an object here. This is my Samsung tablet 3.8. Let's say this is your focus. You're focused on this object. Let's say you're distracted, so the distraction takes your focus away. Where is your focus going? See? And that's it, people. We are being distracted too easily to stuff that we shouldn't even pay attention to. You see? So. Okay. That's just my brother. Okay. So. Think about that, people. Seriously. And I'm not laughing in this video because. Hold on. Close the door. I'm not laughing this video, guys, because this is a very serious matter. You see? Distractions can be dangerous. Look, if you are facing a mountain in your life and it's very, very stressful and you don't know how to deal with it, okay, then give that mountain to Christ and ask Him and give all the burdens to Him, and then you relax, okay, and let the Holy Spirit guide you in what you're going to do next, okay? Don't Okay, if you recognize that there's a mountain in your life, something very stressful that you can't handle, don't just escape to something else. Because that's just an escape, but the mountain is still there. The Lord Jesus said, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you would say to this mountain, lift up and be thrown into sea, and the mountain would obey you. That means that you acknowledge that there is a situation that you cannot handle, that you cannot solve. That means that you need to acknowledge that you need Christ, and you acknowledge that you need to have faith. And once you have faith, you exercise your faith by speaking to that mountain, commanding it in the name of Jesus to disappear, to leave you alone, and it will happen. The moment you exercise your authority, and the moment that it really moves, there can be some time in between. In that time between, you keep on following Christ, and you keep on enjoying life, okay? But you're not going to see, okay, that's a mountain, I can't handle it, so let me just watch a soap opera, let me just escape, let me just do something to escape the reality. Because you cannot escape reality. Folks, I have come to end this video now, and this message is very serious. The moment you realize you're becoming attached to something, even if it's something Christian, look out, because you are being bewitched. Okay. May the grace of the Lord Jesus be with you, and watch out.